the Adult Swim bumps, like some of his music was on there.
Like those little snippets in between coming back from commercial?
Then I listened to Kanye's
B-tape.
Original beats. Like
97 B-tape.
That shit's actually like really good. And I'm like,
it's one of the best. I like have it on my phone even. I like that so much.
I get so upset. I'm like, why couldn't you keep making
How far
music
you like have come. Why did you start putting your vocals on songs? Why couldn't you just be like this? No, but that B-tape is fire.
Then I just had like a whole playlist of just like old Adult Swim bumps, like and shit playing. And I got kicked out the party because the guy was like, "Fuck you! You're listening to old school."
Unacceptable.
I'm still gonna show up to your car meet, bro, and play my own music.
So yeah. Your virtual car meet.
My virtual car meet. Yeah. I pulled up in my Porsche. My Dodge Charger.
Came in this thing I got up on the table. That shouldn't be there. Whoops.
It's pretty fun, actually. Like, I don't drive in real life, so I guess maybe that's why.
It's funny, there was a video on Reddit yesterday of this guy doing a driving simulator. He doesn't drive either, and he like ran over somebody in his simulator when he was trying to pass someone on the left, and just the look on his face, because he's not a driver, of like, oh my god, I just hit someone, was too funny.
I know how to drive, I just don't have my license. I can't park. That's the problem.
So while the intro is playing, I do want to ask you this. So the first topic you
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV.
Good morning and welcome to Disputed Takes. I'm Ricardo Jefferson, and today, Flip and Stephen A. have some important sports topics to talk about. So guys, why don't we jump right into talking about some sports. So the first topic of the day is baseball and the new pitch clock rule that was put into place. It's been about 2 weeks into the regular season. What's your guys' opinions on it, and do you think it's helpful or ruining the game?
I gotta tell you, I think the pitch clock is one of the greatest inventions in the history of the game of baseball, America's national pastime. Never did I ever think that a rule change for something so steady for over 100 years would make me happy about it. I'm normally the guy that wants everything exactly the same. This pitch clock, we're getting families into the seats that weren't coming last year. We're getting more people tuning in on TV. The whole conversation around the game of baseball has totally changed for the positive. Last year, everybody's talking smack about it, knocking baseball. It's lower than soccer now. I'll tell you what, right now, Flip, baseball's making a comeback, and it has to do with the pitch clock.
I absolutely disagree, okay? I absolutely disagree. People are spending loads of money going to these games, and then they're being told, hey, you have to leave in like 2 hours, man. Like, it's not fair to the people who spend their hard-earned money to go to these games in person. And I like how you brought up it's America's national pastime. That's something that you don't change, okay? It's supposed to be traditional things that you don't change. The people that are running baseball now are absolutely ruining the national pastime that is baseball. They're ruining the tradition. They hate baseball. And it's so sad to see, in my opinion. The pitch clock is a horrible creation. It's not fair to the people in person It's not fair to the real fans of baseball. It's only fair to the new people who never watched the sport ever, and they're trying to have this new, like, you know, they're trying to have this train of thought not be killed because they're used to watching sports like basketball and football that have timers. So they have to have a attention span for that.
So you think that a four-hour game where people are going on their phones the whole time is better than a two-and-a-half-hour game that keeps people moving and engaged? No. No way.
I absolutely disagree.
Of course you do.
I disagree, because I have to disagree. But I disagree. Like, it's not fair to people who are going to spend hundreds or thousands of dollars. Imagine going to a Yankee game and you buy the seats right behind home plate. You just spent almost $2,000 on a ticket and you're there for an hour and a half, 2 hours, when you used to be there for 3 hours having a good time. Yes. Now you can't have a good time because you have to pay attention all the time, and it's not right.
You have to pay attention. You act like that's a bad thing. I'd rather be paying attention. I don't want to get hit by a foul ball. I want to catch a foul ball.
I don't know. I absolutely disagree. I think it's a horrible creation. And it's not good for baseball, okay? That's the end of it. That's the end of it for me.
All right, we have a pretty serious topic now regarding the advertisement of fast food restaurants on sports channels like ESPN and Fox Sports during sporting events. The biggest example recently is the Burger King commercials that are constantly playing on ESPN. Do you guys think it's appropriate for sports channels to promote unhealthy fast food chains?
Ricardo, absolutely not. It's absolutely not a good thing. We are supposed to be promoting athletics, sports, healthy habits, okay? Fast food eating is not a healthy habit. Look at me. I know it's not a healthy habit, okay? So you shouldn't be eating Burger King. It's disgusting anyway. You shouldn't be eating McDonald's. You shouldn't be eating Popeyes or any of these fried fast food chains. It's not right. Sports channels need to stop promoting this garbage, okay? It's not right. I understand it's a business and they have to do it to make their money, but at the end of the day, it's not right. They need to start promoting healthier things.
You know, this show is called Disputed Takes, but I'm pretty sure this is an undisputed take that fast food is not good, it's not great. And not only that, the new fast food with the new disgusting impossible, it's impossible that I would eat that burger. That's what they should call that burger. Burger King is a mess. McDonald's, a mess. At least Popeye's smells good, but it's a mess. Chaos going on out there in the fast food world. We do not need that in athletics.
Absolutely, Stephen A. And guess what? We on this show, and I'm looking right at the viewers, we would never support these fast food corporations. We would never do it. Keep the camera on me while I'm saying this, okay? We would never support horrible, horrible corporations that have caused the obesity to rise in not only America, but in the entire world. It's not right. ESPN, Fox Sports, do better.
Well, I'll tell you what, Ian, I think you gotta have it your way. So flip it over and get some BK or don't. That's your choice.
Look, I'll tell you this. I am the one and only true Burger King, but at the end of the day, it's not right. Get rid of it. It's disgusting. It's predatory.
All right, interesting takes. We do have to head to commercial break though, but we'll be back with more Disputed Takes.
Whopper, 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 Junior, Double, Triple, Whopper, Flame Grill taste with perfect toppers, I rule this day. Lettuce, mayo, pickle, ketchup, it's okay if I don't want that impossible or bacon, Whopper, any Whopper my way. You rule your season today.
You know, I think we should really cut out the UFO part.
No. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I guess we'll keep it in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
That was too good, right?
Get out! I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, man. Okay.
To the people who reach into a carton of warm, crispy, golden, perfectly salted McDonald's world-famous fries and return with just one. Who are you, and how do you do that? Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
All right, welcome back to Disputed Takes. Guys, I think it's time for some predictions on the NBA playoffs. We spoke to the fans of the show, and they want to hear your predictions on the upcoming Lakers-Grizzlies Game 3 and Knicks-Cavs Game 3 as they're both tied at one apiece. Let's start with you, Flip. Let's hear your predictions for Saturday's Game 3, LA versus Memphis.
Look, Ricardo, the LA Lakers, who are run by LeBum James, the fake GOAT, the man who thinks he's better than Michael Jordan. I got the Jordans on right now, baby. Nobody wears LeBron's. LeBron James, you are horrible. You're a horrible basketball player, okay? You're overrated. Your Lakers are horrible. You're losing Saturday night to the Memphis Grizzlies easily. You lost last night to a team without their star player. Their star player, okay? If he comes back, how do you expect to win any games in the rest of the series? I saw you play against the Timberwolves in the play-in. It was the worst basketball I've ever seen in my entire life. The Lakers are horrible. The Grizzlies are going to win on Saturday night, and they're going to win the rest of the series.
Let's go to a little quiz time right now, Flip, okay? Who's the leading scorer in the history of the National Basketball Association?
Look, LeBron James has played how many seasons? How old is he still?
How are you going to use that against him, the fact that he stayed healthy his whole career and he's been so amazing?
It's stat padding. Do we talk crap about Russell Westbrook for stat padding when he was doing his triple-double stuff?
Padding is not playing 18 years healthy. Stat padding is making assists in a game that doesn't matter anymore.
Look, if Michael Jordan didn't end up retiring twice, if he didn't go to college for a few years, he would outscore LeBron easily. So that's not even an argument. It's a horrible argument. You can't make that argument.
That's all right. I'm not even trying to make it about LeBron versus Jordan. I'm just trying to say that if you got someone in the conversation for the best player of all time, you can't just throw the series away and say Memphis is going to run away with it.
I can't agree with that. I absolutely cannot agree with that.
You can't agree with anything I say, can you, Flip?
I'm not supposed to. The game last night, they absolutely lost to a team that was being ran basically by Draymond Green 2.0. So the Lakers are in trouble. And they also have injury-prone Anthony Davis. They're not winning the game the rest of the series.
Draymond Green 2.0, did somebody step on somebody else and I didn't realize it? Are you talking about for a different reason he's like Draymond Green? Because Draymond Green brings that energy that I wish players on the Lakers had to bring them out of this hole against the Grizzlies. But you know what? LeGod is going to pull them out of the hole anyway.
Oh, God.
Now, Stephen A., your Knicks are heading home to Madison Square Garden tomorrow night for Game 3 against the Cavs. What are your predictions for the game?
Win. Win, 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 okay? This isn't about the Knicks being better. This is about the Knicks responding after getting their butts kicked in Game 2. That was an embarrassment. And let me tell you something. Tom Thibodeau knows it was an embarrassment more than anybody else on that roster. He is not letting them come out onto the court for Game 3 without being ready, ready, ready. The Cavs said they would be ready for Game 2. I'll tell you what, behind that home crowd, the Knicks going to be ready for Game 3. And I'm sure Flip is going to try to debate this too, so go for it. But let me tell you something. Knicks, Knicks, Knicks in 6.
I absolutely disagree. Okay, I have to disagree, but I absolutely disagree. The Cleveland Cavaliers, they have a much superior team, okay? They have the star power the New York Knicks do not have. The Knicks decided, hey, I'm not going to trade for the next best guy in the league, Donovan Mitchell, who just so happens to also be on the Cleveland Cavaliers right now. He has a vendetta against the New York Knicks. He's going to go into his hometown, and he's going to destroy the Knicks, just like Trae Young did a few years ago.
Listen, I think that you are all kinds of crazy on this one, okay? Trey ain't got a hair left on his head that's gonna help him beat the Knicks this time around, okay? The Knicks are clearly better than the Cavaliers, okay? Donovan Mitchell, one of about 10 people in the league that average over 30 points this year, not exactly like he's the only one doing it. And, oh, that's right, the Knicks still have 5 first-round picks that the Cavaliers don't have. They finished 2 games behind them in the regular season. I'd say the Knicks are doing okay. And if they get everybody healthy, Randall, Hart, Brunson, good luck, Cavaliers. Ain't happening in New York.
The Knicks are chokers. And Julius Randle is not a playoff performer. I'm sorry. The Cleveland Cavaliers are going to sweep the rest of the series. And that's it. That's all Flip has to say about that.
Well, guys, it looks like that's all with the time we have for today. For my good friends, Flip Baymore and Stephen Naismith, I'm Ricardo Jefferson. We'll see you guys next time here on Disputed Takes.
Disputed Takes is brought to you by Burger King. At BK, have it your way. You rule. By McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. And Popeyes. Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Great stuff, people. I got scared. I only heard little clapping. Did something go wrong? I thought it was good.
I know we're under a little bit, but
yeah, that's all right. Under for them to just put up, like they could even play the open again if we were under. Literally. No, yeah, that's better than getting cut off mid-sentence. Good stuff, good stuff, good cues, thank you, good camera, good living.